Hey guys, it's Spade, and I'm here with another episode of me trying to get onto the Tigers. Let's see what we got on deck today. Let's check the standings real quick. Three games back. So we got some work to do in the standings. I believe the All-Star race, though, we are looking pretty good. Yeah, set number one. Nice low ERA, nice low whip. Let's see what we can do to add to this for our calendar today. We got another three-game set with the Altoona Curve. Obviously, we only won one of the last ones, so we got some work to do. And let's get it started, guys.
As we look at this young pitcher.
Yeah. I really need to go through and turn those off because you can do that. I'm just too lazy. Playing left out here today. I've got four bats against you guys. Haven't done anything, so that's fun. If we can actually beat these guys down today, or the next 3 days, it's going to do a lot for us here.
Alex Fajardo gets the call for game. Next to dig in.
All right, what are we looking at here?
No one aboard for it, and two gone here in the first. Out in front there as this one's pulled off to the left side.
Okay, can't swing it, that's the kind of stuff, but okay.
Two out, nobody on. And he comes back with a fastball strike.
And should have swung at that, so that's fine. That's a quick inning. Finally, a nice little fielding opportunity.
This is hit the other way out toward left field. Perry will get there and he puts it away to retire the side.
Nice and routine.
Doing here this half to the bottom of inning number four we go, and we are tied nothing nothing. Now at the plate here is George Perry.
I would love to see us get another home run.
First pitch coming, here it is.
That was not it.
High pop up. Tucker is there. And that's the second out of the inning.
Sometimes I just, I really want him to just drop it one time, and I get to second base because of that. We literally got one guy that can get a hit off these guys so far, so. Now he's got two hits, so that's good, but, you know.
He's ready. Here's the first pitch. Now he starts to chase a pitch outside.
Wow.
Pull the bat back in time. It's strike one.
All right.
Lifted in the air to center.
Got a good piece of that. He took a bad route. And it didn't matter.
A nice running play to record the second.
Right, bases are juiced. Let's not just let this be me chasing a home run that I don't have a chance to catch. That'd be great. There we go.
One run scores, but not the second. So one run here, one hit, no errors.
There we go.
Not too many more shots left. Home half of the eight.
All right, guys. We got a chance to tie it up. This guy does not throw gas.
No hits in three tries so far. Unless struck out once. Out in front here is this one. Scorched foul to the left. Lousy, the runner at first with two gone.
That's in the gap. Not enough for me to go two.
So now they'll have runners on the corners, but two away.
You know, Dero, there's been some great pitching in this one so far. After that knock, that's only the third hit of the game, and we're getting late into this one.
Yeah, they always say you gotta tip your hat to the opposition sometimes. Well, I think this offense is tired of tipping its hat. They gotta start to swing their bats a little bit better. That's their third knock of the game. I know it's late, but maybe they can get something going.
And the inning will end as they're unable to cash in with two outs.
Come on.
Now to bat, Robbie Glendinning grounded out in his last at bat. Skied in the air to straightaway left. Perry is under it and he
can of corn.
Catch for out number three.
Can of corn, guys. All right, so not the start that we wanted to the series.
Used a nice fifth inning to take the lead, and they never gave it back. Brennan Malone notches his third win of the year as he allows only two hits through seven. The show's continuing coverage of Double-A Northeast League Baseball. Tarek Skoll, the southpaw out of the Golden State.
Hey, here we go. We actually get some people on base.
Next will be the designated hitter. George Perry, throw over to the bag, and the runner back safely. First pitch on its way. Runners on the move for second. Pitch misses low. The throw down, and it's not in time as he's in.
Nice job, buddy.
Well, he's certainly doing his best to get his team out to an early lead. Picks up the single and then decides that's not good enough, so he swipes second to get into scoring position. Now we'll see if the guys can pick him up.
That's inside. 2-0. Yeah, you should take a look at our visiting club as they enter play here this evening. They're on a great run of late as they come in winners of seven of their last nine games.
Yeah, Maddie, they started yesterday off on the right foot. If they can put together two games in a row, a lot of positive vibes start happening. You never know. This could be a jump start to big things.
Hit hard up the middle, right to him. And he'll whip this one over to
gets him to third, so that's something. We got to start working them in. I got to start working into better counts. That's going to give me better opportunities. I just haven't been doing it.
Here's a looping fly ball out to right. In there, a base hit.
Well, that's what's so disappointing.
That's not how you want to get on base, but it works.
Really good pitch, and yet this guy's so big and so strong, he's able to muscle it into right field for a base hit. Yeah, you hand your batting gloves to the first base coach right there, and you thank your lucky stars. That's a nice hit.
Oh, come on.
Take second.
Well, I'm not sure if he was going on his own or that came from the dugout, but either way, he didn't give himself much of a chance with the lead.
They just went yard three times to tie it up, so that's not ideal. We can't get anybody on base. All right, guys, bring me home.
It's only the sixth inning, but you love to claim the lead right now and let your bullpen carry the load the rest of the way.
Number 17.
Next, it'll be Josh Lester. No hits to this point. Swing and a drive to right. There it goes.
That will do it. Jeez.
Serves one up, a reliever's worst nightmare, and a big confidence boost to the lineup. Let's see if he can rebound.
Not a lot of exit velocity on that, just the right angle. I did have the same approach because he threw a meatball right down the middle, but it didn't work. If you guys can hear my kid in the background going crazy, that's a big win for us though. All right, let's get another one. Ooh, or not. Oh, we get to pitch a little bit today. Good. So here we go.
So stepping in is Matthew Raymo, and we are set for baseball here this evening. Underway now for Sunday Night Baseball as the first pitch is swung on and missed as we get the series finale underway. Fellas, you take a look at our home standing ball club as
we
this one tonight. They come in on the heels of a victory last
just
time.
Eating out of my hand. Fighter way off. Bury this two-seamer inside.
Hit to short. He's got it. And quickly there are two away.
I'd appreciate it if you put a little bit more arm behind that.
At the plate now is Pablo Sixto. First chance for him here in the top of the first with nobody on.
Oh, there's a hit.
And that finds some outfield grass.
Hung that bad boy. Oh, wow. Okay.
3-2. 3-2. Two out. Runner on first. Lots of possible outcomes on this pitch. And that ball gets down.
He's scoring.
It should be extra bases.
He's going 3.
He pulls into third safely as they jump.
Not a great look right there.
And the pitcher was this close to getting out of the inning. Just a sec now. Is that ball?
Well. Thank you.
Third crosses the plate, the tag, and they'll get him at second. And with that,
perfect. All right, we tied it up.
Now to the plate here is Sky.
Let's get these guys back here.
Second, rounded down the third baseline. This gets foul. It's 0-1. Now here it comes.
Keep that same level. I'm just going to change sides of plate.
And it's fouled away.
Because I want to set him up for the split finger. Or the...
Here comes the 1-2.
That I hung. Backdoor slider.
Here's another 1-2. Swing and a miss on the slider, and that's out number one.
That's a pretty impressive pitch from a young arm like that. If you can spot your pitches there, and advantage counts like 1-2, strikeouts, soft contact.
Johnny Cruz stands in as he looks at a cold strike.
Hit this cold zone.
Starting to go around there. Come
on, be wet.
Tossed over 30 innings so far this season and has allowed just over one run per nine innings. An ERA in the low ones.
Let's keep it going.
And a splutter.
Easy.
Missed that time, and that'll be out number two.
He's looking first inning was pretty much a mess, but I give him credit for letting it go and making some really good adjustments.
And now, Robbie Glendinning. She'll go after the first pitch and bounce it into foul territory. He'll work on keeping this top of the second alive.
Let's go. Two-seamer down and in.
Now a swing and a little bouncer softly hit to the right side of the mound. Throw in time and the side is retired. So they go down.
Should the catcher have taken that, maybe?
On now to the bottom of the second, and we are tied.
Do I care? No, not really. Big inning from us, four runs.
Digging in will be Martin Pabst. He'll stand in to open things up here in the third.
They've gotten a gut punch to start this game. There's no doubt about this, but that's when you have to turn the scoreboards off. Everybody do their job one at bat at a time.
Let's go.
Fouls this one off. Into the windup. Here comes the 0-2 pitch.
Slider off.
Swing and a miss as he picks up another one. Make it four strikeouts already, and there's your first out. That one'll be Matthew Raimer.
Back to the problem part of the order.
Yeah, he didn't put up much of a fight either, Matt. You gotta find a way. Can't go down three pitches. I don't care if you're staring at him or swinging at him. You have to find a way to make this pitcher work a little bit harder.
1-1 the count. And now a pitch on the way.
Well, he's doing better so far.
Check swing here as he couldn't help himself, and it's ruled strike two. One out, nobody on. Swung on and missed his fifth strikeout already, and there are two gone in the inning. Digging in next, Dan Plaza, over 1 for him here in this one.
A slayer. I'm having a problem timing my off speed a little bit here.
Lofted in the air out toward right center. Here comes the right fielder.
Come on.
Well, last time this guy had some success, but he can't seem to get it going here. In fact, he's given him more hits in this one than he did his entire last outing. And we're only in the third inning.
Ready with the nothing and one pitch. A swing and a miss and a slider for a strike.
I'll tell you, if I'm pitching right now, I'm not throwing anything near the strike zone until these guys prove they can lay off it. They're just being way too aggressive.
Count is 1-2 now. Got him swinging, and that will end the inning. One hit.
Can't trust my defense, evidently, so. Gotta strike him out.
The Seawolves are out on top, 6-2.
All right, quick turnaround. I think this outing is going to hurt my all-star for sure. Because it just hasn't not been pretty.
This guy's locating, feeling really good about his fastball. Two back-to-back.
Weak roller, right side. And out at first as he almost beat him to the bag that time, but the foot just beats the runner for out number two. Pitch on the way. That's popped up. Left fielder coming.
Got him.
On. He tracks it down, and that will end the inning. So they're held in check here this half of the inning. Leading off the inning, it'll be.
All right, we're getting these guys pretty far out of range. Kind of play with my pitches a little bit here. Maybe not play that much though.
Swung on and missed. Really fooled him that time for the first out.
Well, you can tell by their approach that they're going to go up there and try to be aggressive off this guy, but he's taking full advantage of that. He's pounding the zone with strikes, and right now we're seeing a lot of swings and misses and a lot of strikeouts and no walks either.
And he lays off a
come on, blue.
Pretty good, but it's 2-0.
Now, you've got a 6-run lead out there. there's no reason not to go right at guys. You have to keep attacking the zone.
And it's two balls and two strikes now.
Slider away.
He stays alive, still 2-2. Bases are empty, one man out.
Hit him with a split finger.
And another foul ball.
And can't catch up to that.
And that's 8 strikeouts thus far. That's
not speed, it's just location.
Second time here as he looks at a ball high, 1-0. Heading out towards shallow right. And no trouble for him as he makes the catch to end the inning. So no runs, no hits, no errors.
All
right.
This is probably my last inning or my second to last inning. Just because of what I've been doing. Done.
No problem over there at first as they record the out. So they breeze through this half of the inning.
All right, guys, here we go.
New inning set to get underway. And standing in the outfielder, Cal Mitchell, trying to check it in its 0-1.
Easily done. Easily done. See if I can get a double play ball here.
Tom flew out last time up. Split finger pitches in there for strike one. And he takes strike two.
Looks like he's got a good
backdoor slider.
Fastball this far into the game. He's used it really effectively tonight.
So it was a strikeout looking there. Guy Tom goes down for out number two in the top half. Sent on the ground out to second. Reined in. First beats him easily, and the side is retired. This one pretty well in the bag. Stepping in once again,
get another inning.
Robbie Glendinning. We're in the eighth now, and nothing's changed out there on the mound.
Nah, they just haven't had much of an answer, Matty. They've been off balance and baffled all game. He's got a nice, comfortable lead. You have to think he's going to pound the strike zone. But here, get aggressive.
Hey, even though this guy's a righty hitter, he's going to get pounded with that two-seamer. He needs to make sure he catches this thing out front if he sees that pitch again.
Breaking ball that drops in for a strike.
Well, he's done a real nice job with that breaking ball this start. That's not the first time he's locked the guy up with it.
I'm going to risk walking this guy.
Bouncer to the left side. Fielded cleanly. Throw on to first in time, so the leadoff man is set down to open up inning number 8.
There we go. So I was about to get eaten alive, I'm sure. And that's it. We'll go on to win the series. 5th win of the year. Not a terrible line. A lot of hits in that first inning. But outside of that, it was pretty good, though. All right, guys. Well, that's going to wrap up this one. We had a pretty good outing. And this is Spade out.